Hi and welcome. My name is Harshit Daga and I work as a senior software consultant at Noldus. In this video, I'll be talking about union types that is coming up with Scala 3. Scala 3 is a new Scala programming language that is about to release by the end of this year. Okay, so union type is a type which is one of a set of other type, or if I say a type of a variable or expression which can consist of multiple types. Okay, so let me show you by writing a small piece of method. Let's say I have a method name example, so which takes a parameter p, which can be one of integer, string, or let's say boolean. So, and if I write something called p dot match case of type integer, it's integer case of type boolean and case of type string. Okay, so as you can see, the variable or value p, which is capable of holding any one of the three mentioned types, which can be either integer or string or boolean. So if I call something like this, so this is a very fair and valid statement, because false is a type of boolean and the example method is capable of handling boolean. And if I write something, this is a string, which is also a valid statement. And if I write something called integer, which is also a valid statement. But if I write something, if I give input to this method, which is none of these three, for example, if I give something double, okay, so obviously the code is not going to compile, because you are giving input as double, but the method is expecting one of these three types, okay, so which is fair enough. And and if you see, union types are commutative by nature. By commutative nature, it means like you can shuffle these type anywhere. So like if I say, if I write something like this, so which is also a fair and equivalent statement. So if I say boolean union int union string, so it which is same as int union boolean union string, so that is why they are commutative. Okay, and I'll add one more example here by introducing type inference of the statements or a method which give you multiple types. So for example, if I write something small statement, 11 is greater than 44, then return me and string a string, otherwise otherwise return me a integer value. Okay, and if I ask you to find me the type, to infer me the type of this statement, so the compiler will give you type any, because if by the nature, the least upper bound of string and integer type is any, so that is why compiler is giving you type any if by default you do not explicitly provide any type. But if you want, you can also explicitly write this type and compiler will not complain, it would work. And and if you want to give input to this method, so that will also work, because boolean, integer, string, union type is super type of string union integer, and that is also a valid statement. So one last thing about union type is like union type pattern matching on union type are exhaustive. For example, in this method named example, you have a union of boolean, integer or string, and if by chance you miss applying pattern for any one of the type, let's say boolean, so this compiler will give you a warning that the match may not be exhaustive because it would fail on pattern case true and false, which is obviously a boolean. So that is very nice thing that even if you by chance miss to write pattern for any one of your type, so compiler will give you a warning and then you can act upon that explicitly. So yeah, that's all for the union types. Hope you like this video. Thank you very much.